So the question and answer website Quora announced it is the latest company to fall victim to a huge data breach. Quora says the names, email addresses, and passwords of some 100 million users were compromised by a, quote, malicious third party. And while this data breach is the latest, it is not the worst by a long shot. CNN senior political analyst John Avlon has your grim data reality check, sir.
Your grim reality check. Look, every week it seems we get news of a new massive data hack. Problems are becoming so prevalent that the question increasingly isn't who's been hacked, but who hasn't. Because the unbelievable number of people impacted, it becomes easy to just accept it. And this phenomenon even has a name. It's called breach fatigue. But we all need to stay awake and vigilant. The most recent headline-grabbing breach is at Marriott, where some 500 million of its customers may have had their data stolen. Everything from addresses to credit cards, dates stayed, where and when, even passport numbers. To put this in perspective, there are only 329 million people in the United States. Marriott says it responded quickly, but security experts point out that this hack started back in 2014. And Marriott had a chance to stop it a year later and missed. It's a story we hear over and over. Big companies hoping that big data breaches will just blow over. And now here come the lawyers. At least one lawsuit against Marriott is seeking a class action status and $12.5 billion in damages, which sounds like a lot until you do the math and figure out that's only $25 per hacked victim. The lawyers, of course, hope to get much, much more money. Now, but as bad as the Marriott breach is, it's only the second worst in U.S. history. Top prize goes to the 2013 Yahoo hack that compromised the personal information of some 3 billion people. That's more than twice the population of China, folks. And that's not even Yahoo's only entry in the top five. It's tied for second with Marriott, with the data breach impacting 500 million folks in 2014. And this fall, we saw another massive breach, this time at Facebook, that exposed the very personal information of around 30 million people. The company says no financial information was compromised, but what was compromised is in some ways worse. Religion, relationship status, gender preference, even places the user had been. It took Facebook 11 days to plug the leak after it was found internally. And now several senators are calling for action, building on an idea about an online privacy bill of rights, and now suggesting everything from limiting how long companies can store customer data to jail time for CEOs who callously ignore privacy concerns. Senator Mark Warner argues we must not accept this hack attack trend as the new normal. And so far, we've only been talking about data breaches that cost money and people's identities, which is bad enough. But this week, we also found out what happens when hacking turns deadly. A Saudi dissident friend of Jamal Khashoggi believes that some 400 WhatsApp messages that he shared with the murdered journalist were intercepted by Saudi authorities. In the message obtained exclusively by CNN, the pair plotted resistance against Saudi Crown Prince MBS, who Khashoggi called a Pac-Man devouring everything in his way. At one point, Khashoggi's friend realized his phone may have been hacked. "God help us," Khashoggi responded. And 2 months later, he was dead. Khashoggi's friend is now suing the Israeli company that invented the software he believes was used to hack his phone. It says the guilt he feels over his messages contributing to his friend's death is unbearable. Look, if 500 million people had their homes broken into, we'd all be calling it a crisis. And it's time to understand that cybercrime is no less real, and it demands action. And that's your reality check.
It's an important point, John, and I have to say, the minute that I knew the press would pick up on this is when it was Marriott Rewards that had been breached, because every reporter in America is obsessed with reward points there. Now it's real.
Now it's personal. That's right.
That got our attention. Yeah. John Avlon, thank you. Thanks, very much.